Schon.
Young people must learn to dress. Four verses by the Short Pants.
I want to take the chance to say that I blame in the parents. I mean, how you could leave my house dress up like if you's a Mickey Mouse. I mean, I cannot believe some of the way young people dress. It does make me grieve. When you look, I mean you could see, they feel that your dress is a jeans and jersey. Balabade, lubabade, la bam bam bade, la da do, la bam bade, da 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 da. The short pants would like to go further to say they're following trends from America. I mean, I don't want to be slack to criticize, but they're following North American black. I mean, they jersey outside. I mean, a dirty sneakers that can hide. And what is a disgrace? All of them trousers falling off the waist. Balabamba day, lamba doy. What short pants will say will not make you cry. I'm not saying you have to dress in jacket and tie. Understand, I would like to state you have to take into consideration the climate. But I just see them in a vest, walking in tongue, and they feel they properly dress. And what blowing my mind, it is no ease. They have the ball to walk with young ladies. La bamba de la dam bamba do, ba la ba de la dam bamba da la ba do, dam bamba de la da da. I really don't like how young people dress on the road. We should do something to introduce a dress code. I mean, they're doing it in every bar, in every club, theater and cinema. And I find they should also do it on the show. Like when you're coming to hear Kaizo or Extempo. I mean, young people, it is really, really bad. Your dress, I find you should raise the standard.
Let's say a round of applause.
I think he handled the topic well. I liked the way he developed and some of the different angles that he took. I detected just one false rhyme and the repetition with the sneakers, but I think it was acceptable under the circumstances. I particularly like his last two verses. I think he started to get comfortable, and the last verse rounded off nicely. Quite a good job by Short Pants.
Friends carry you, but bring you back. Friends carry you, but don't bring you back. Francois Otley in position number two, backed up by the Kelly Green and Harmony aggregation.
Friends carry you, but don't bring you back. Okay.
Just pick is a topic that is real fantastic, because in young people, goodness, they say they lack. Because friends could lead you, but they can't bring you back. You must teach your children to behave good and be exemplars in their neighborhood. So when people bring drugs and influence, they could tell them gone from me with that damn nonsense. La la la. Pervasive in this society is the problem of juvenile delinquency. They're breaking the law, they're robbing you and me. People want to migrate out this blessed country. Because you see the same friends that take them there, it's the same friends that will not take them anywhere. They will leave them there and they will get their kicks, but it's not them who will have to be in court facing licks. La 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 la. Pampaya na 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 ho. La 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 la. Yeah yeah. Santi Manite. We look on the news daily. Tell me what we see in plenty of on the TV. A lot of mothers crying for their children, and a lot of hungry women, because their husband said he was a thug, and he was involved in crime and all kind of drugs. So I will tell you now, treat them right. Listen to the message of Francois Hartley tonight. La 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 la. They're smoking weed. Who are these children that they want to lead? They need to study all their work and don't study no bad man posing and joke. The youth of today very intelligent, because they could help out the establishment. They could turn it around as they turn it back, because they say friends will lead you but they not bring you back. Thank you.
We saw the name Francois Hartley earlier, we wondered who this would be, and now I saw the, seen the person, I know exactly who he is. In fact, he's the son of a late friend of mine I went to school with, actually. And he recently, about a year or two ago, won a competition for youths singing songs by other Calypsonians. So he's quite a talented guy, good voice. And I thought he did quite a fine job.
Absolutely. Flowed very easily. Never seemed to stumble.
That's what I liked about his performance.
Topic, North Stand, R.I.P. Rest in peace. North Stand, rest in peace.
North Stand,
R.I.P.
R.I.P. R.I.P. Rest in peace. I think a lot of people wanted to rest in peace in Harlem after the lovely time they had on the greens.
Eric.
Somewhere around the early 50s, I'm telling you, now listen to me please. I want all your people to understand, in the savannah we only had the grandstand. But then some way after independence, you know they decided to break the fence. I tell you the truth, listen to me as man. And they decided to erect the North Stand. Lava day, da 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 day. Lava day, balaba da ba day. Balaba ba day. Well, ever since the North Stand in the savannah, whether it's panorama or the mashgra, I telling you, listen to me pal, or even for the extempo final. You know everybody used to like to go there, drink of the rum, whiskey, also beer. I tell you the truth, whether day or night, it was bacchanal, commerce, and even fight. Telling you man, don't think I am strange, but the only constant sticker in life is change. I telling you, since the development, especially with this new government, they decide to build a new cultural complex. Yes man, hear what they do next. They mush up the savannah stages man, and you know they move the North Stand and grandstand. Day, la ba day, ba la ba da. I telling you the truth for sure. From now on the North Stand it is no more. I used to go there as a little child, and when I get big I used to go there and make style. But now again they demolish the place. I feel the cry and then wipe my face. I telling you, my tears wouldn't cease. I want to say to the North Stand, may you rest in peace. Balabade, thank you. Balabade,
thank you very much. An experienced performance in the sense that he took this at a very fast tempo. Joseph Otto Laplacilaire.
Laplacilaire, known as Lingo. Lingo. Performing
a
there.
A pretty fast clip, I thought. But I thought there was some timing problems with the band that he might have not been entirely listening. But all we have right. The next person on, so let's go that way.
Bring back the Kyato Nine Tails.
Contestant number four, Mark John, contender. His topic, bring back the Cat and Nine Tails.
Well, today, when I look at our jails, I say, bring back the Cat and Nine Tails. We live in a dread time. People are sure all you see is too much a crime. I say, both young and old, the crime rate we have to control. And I say, look, we mustn't fail. You got to agree, bring back the Kyato 19. This is no lie, you'll agree, the crime rate real high. Atrocious crimes every day, is trouble all the way. Crime is on the increase, and these people getting on like this. So I'm telling you, look, we mustn't fail. What to do? Bring back the Kyato 19. Punishment is too severe, but I want to tell them they're wrong. Such punishment will keep the crime rate down. I say it used to control crime. It was really effective long time. So the contenders say the Kyato Nine will control crime today. Dread, my friend, we have to control both adults and children. So I make a request to the government. This thing they must implement. And I'm telling you, we don't flop. If you introduce the tail, the crime going to drop. Thank you.
Mark John, the contender there, Cat and Nine Tails.
Yes, taking it at a slower tempo, and you know, I found everything was carefully done, no false rhymes or anything like that. I could have done with a little bit more development of the topic, though.
Lovely. Well, Black Sage is about to pick his topic.
How to solve the traffic problem. day. It had too much traffic on all them highway. You leave 6 o'clock, I am making joke. 8 o'clock, reach and still you can't reach to work. Well, you know, it had plenty traffic. People wanted to know just how to solve it. Well, I have sense, I am not a chimp. Maybe they should use a helicopter or the blimp. They're telling them long time, please don't find it strange. They say, Mr. Manning, please build the interchange. When you build that, without any doubt, it go ease up the traffic going on in south. But you know, I was very hurt when I see what was done by Mr. Coleman Burt. He built a kind of leeway. I get horrors for that thing he built. It cost $10 million. It is not very sweet. It had too much car on Trinidad Street. Because Trinidad has so much money, it have a car there for everybody. So I want to tell people, I tell them flat, look, it's time they should control that. But the government gets so much abuse when they try to control them foreign used. And on the road, please don't get shocked. It's a big container and too much big truck. And what I find is really the crime. All of them using the road at the same time. Let the car use it in the day, that is right. All them big truck and container use it in the night. But they're not thinking under no pretense. Innovative things like somebody don't have no sense. Lama nine nine, lama lama nine. Thank you very much.
Taxi. Hoping the Minister of Works was listening. Ways to solve the traffic problem. And now, the only lady in the lineup tonight, give her a big hand. Leslie Ann Bristow, Lady Africa. Very consistent performer.
And kidnappers.
From the Cat O' Nine Tails to something even more drastic, hang kidnappers. Lady Africa, Leslie Ann Bristow.
Kidnap, you're really killing a soul.
kidnap and let hang in be the penalty. Them down in a hole. That is why the rope should go round their neck. Then for people life they will have some respect. The hanging thing I really don't condone, but it's something I feel we all have to own. Because with the hanging, yes, when you hang them up, only somehow that way the crime rate will drop.
Lady Africa, contestant number 6 in tonight's first round in the 2007 Extempo Finals. We move on now to contestant number 7, Sheldon John. Giving him a round of applause, please. Your topic is, Sheldon?
National Service, a way to reduce crime.
Yeah. His topic, National Service, one way to reduce crime.
Just now, National Service, let me see that topic. A way to reduce crime, yeah. One way. A way, yeah.
Have it hard because crime does be happening right in the backyard. They don't take the privilege to call the police. Something like that might make the crime rate cease, but they don't understand, man, it's all a we have to come together to build we country. And when we do that, I will tell you, in a matter of time, the National Service is going to reduce crime. As a national, I tell you, it is your duty to make sure and say good morning to everybody. It's not to say you're ignoring the stupidness. It's not to say that you're minding your neighbor business. But you have to realize that red, white, and black to the world right now is under attack. And once I say that, we will reduce the war and crime, cause the National Service right now, it's like crime. More bacchanal, but the national goal, little international. And what I am saying, please don't find me mad. You know we have police here now from Scotland Yard, so we bring them down, man, to help we. Because like we don't believe in we nationality, but once we come together as one, as a national, assure the crime thing go down. So if you see a thief, you're want to bridge the gap. Call the police also if you hear about a kidnap. A man pushing by your corner, why you don't want him alive? I don't know why you take up the phone and call 555. We have to leave this thing, we have to leave it behind. Once you see crime, please dial 999. We will call the crime and the bacchanal. For we to deal with crime, we must be more national. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
John, they're the defending champion. And we're going to take in some messages. We'll be back to get the next contestant.
National service, a way to reduce crime. Contestant number 7. We come now to our final contestant tonight in the first round. He is Myron Bruce, going by the sobriquet, the incredible Myron B.
West Indies winning the World Cup.
The incredible Myron B. Myron Bruce, West Indies winning the World Cup.
Good song, good evening. West Indies winning the World Cup.
When I hear this topic, my heart nearly drop. They say West Indies winning the World Cup. Well, I telling you, I don't have no fear, cause the World Cup staging right down here. I go in to back up my big cooler. You see me running down from the savannah. Because I'm telling you this, I'm telling you, pal, I was see we win the World Cup in the Oval. Yeah! This, you know, we did it fine back in 75 and 79. You know that them boys under Clive Lloyd show all the world how them is good boys. They're playing with class, they're playing with skill. It's only the victory go take we to the hill. Now I telling you, I don't have no fear, we surely go win the World Cup this year. With skill, we have players with class. Look at Brian Lara, the most world class. Chris Gayle, Sawan and Chander Paul. I don't think them other team have chance at all. We go in to ensure we get a victory to unite the Caribbean community. We surely going to take the World Cup, I say. That is the way them boys going to play. Ha ha! Will bring plenty joy. We go in to show the world how we good boy. Not telling you this, I'm telling you plain. All over the world going to never be the same. The people going to see the West Indies are players of class under the trees. I'm telling you now, it's with a breeze. We going to win this World Cup with plenty ease. Thank you.
And that was the final contestant there, the incredible Myron. Myron Bruce, West Indies winning the World Cup. Those are the, that's round one.
A very, very difficult round. And remember,
to the semi-final round of the Extempo competition. I have here the results as tabulated by the judges. And this means we have 4 semi-finalists. And they are Lingo, as I call the names, could you come on stage, please? Myron Bruce. The incredible Mr. B. Philip Murray, Black Sage. And Leslie Ann Bristow, Lady Africa. Those are our four semi-finalists.
Money don't solve problems.
That's the topic, money don't solve problems. Four verses each. One, two. Here's your mic. What arrangement with the band?
E minor, good for you.
Yeah, yeah.
E as an A.
Yeah.
E as an A.
To make it pass.
They give us a topic, I will say, my friends. It is money does not solve problems. What I had to say between me and you. Would you believe that topic is true? Some people feel they very happy when in their pocket they have a whole set of money. But you could have plenty money, I'm sure, and in your heart you're still spiritually poor.
La-ba-dam-ba-da-de.
La-ba-dam-ba-da-de.
Mr. Black Sage, what you just tell we, I telling you, my friend, I cannot agree. Because I telling you, you might think that I'm funny, but I have to solve my problems with my money. I watching at you and the way you dress tonight, my friend. Well, I am impressed. You get some money and you're not confused, cause look at you tonight, your hat is matching your shoes.
I does always tell everybody that this fella who playing blind, he could see. Because this fella called Lingo, he is a big imposter, you know. But ladies and gents, what makes me sad? It has so much money in Trinidad. It has so much money, I will say one time. And this government still cannot solve the crime.
You, my friend, please do not stop. Eventually, the crime going to stop. But I telling you, my friend, to listen me plain. I have to throw away my cane. So tonight, if I should win a good prize, I telling you, you must realize I going to put an end to my street. I going to buy two pair of eyes. I wouldn't be blind again.
Lingo, my friend, you must realize you are living in a fool's paradise. You had to pay plenty, plenty money if you really, really want to see this extempo prize. I will tell you flat, this extempo prize, it can't achieve that. If you win it, you'll just get more horrors. You can't see with just $50,000.
Coming from my heart, $50,000 is a good start. I telling you, listen me, my friend, that $50,000 could solve my problem. Because right now I am making strife. The truth is, I am also looking for a wife. So if I should win the prize as man, for One thing I'm going to do to look for a woman.
La ba 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 ya.
Ba la ba de.
La ba 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 ya. Well, Lingo, I understand you're telling me you have to look for a woman. But Lingo, my friend, I go tell you flat, not even money could achieve that. Because if you get a good lady, she will only like you for your money. And since you are blind, it is very true, you can't look for a woman, woman have to look for you.
You say that I blame, and that is true, but I could always look for a woman too. I'm telling you, well, me I'm making strife, even though I don't have a wife. But I'm telling you, don't feel like funny, I could do plenty things with my money. I could spend all my money for many years, because with money, you know, I could make plenty fears.
Thank you very much, Backstage and Lingo, our first semi-final pair. Yeah, come on, come on. First class. Election 2007 could be interesting. Lady Africa and Myron B.
Everybody out there is aware 2007 is an election year. I don't know the date that they're planning, but I know for sure it's very interesting. One thing, now that you see that we have three very good parties, so I waiting with bated breath, because I know it will be a fight to the death.
Election is bad, because that will be very, very hard. People don't know which party to choose, cause to me, seems like all of them go lose. Because B&M causing real problems, COP can't help not nobody. Don't talk about the blasted UNC, them go come back to thief with all we money.
Myron boy, I want you to note all of what they're doing to get we vote. They're going all up in Malik, trying to woo the voters up there with trick. But I am telling you all right now, I voting, I have to vote somehow. And I know it will be interesting, I know that my party going to win.
Lady Africa, listen to that. I want to know which party go in this flat, because all of them just bad. If they have a good party in Trinidad, the people fed up of the war and crime. They fed up of the price raising all the time. They don't want nobody, they might not believe, because all of them is blasted thieves.
Bada bada.
Little boy, you only out of place. Look, your mother's milk still on your face. People out there, just let me explain. Never before did he get his finger stained. So he don't know nothing about election. What he have there is mere projection. I telling you, I have no problem. My party always is the PNM.
Saying that, trying to be wise, but saying that would not get you this here first prize. Look at the people, we open we eyes, we seeing that they could no longer mesmerize. They're trying hard to cover the thing with all kind of blimp and fancy things. But look at the people suffering bad, and that is why we don't want them in Trinidad.
I don't know about the things that you happen on, but they really have no competition. One party leader, he is a crook. He making jail any way you look. The next one, I tell you with respect, but he is a PNM reject. And that is why I am waiting, because I know election go be interesting.
Ba-da-ba-dim, ba-dam, ba-da-dai.
Ba-da-ba-do-ba-dai. Ba-da-ba-do-ba-dai.
Even though my mother milk might be on my face, I'm seeing what really happening in this place. People can't get house, they can't get food. Lady Africa, I think you're just being rude. It's time that you get out of this thinking that PNM go always solve everything. Now let me tell you this, it's going to be hard, because we don't want them in Trinidad.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Ba-da-ba-do-ba-dai. Ba-da-ba-do-ba-dai.
Chocolate Allen gives us hope.
Chocolate Allen gives us hope. Over to you, Lingo. Music. Maestro, please.
So we're going to hear now Chocolate Allen Gives Us Hope. That's the topic there. And each one is allowed 6 verses. In this, the Ex-Temple War.
Malabade. Just the other day, recently, I was passing in front the library. I'm telling you, right now as man, I see the daughter of a big time Kaisonian. I'm telling you, I must explain, was the little child called Chocolate Allen. She saw down there and she making time, because you know she didn't make a statement against crime.
Chocolate made a nice stand, I will say one time. She made a very nice stand on a crime. But you know, I don't want to make no fuss. With that stand, I am suspicious. Because I am telling all your flat, I know it's Kurt Allen lead her up to that. His career is done, so please consider. He want to make Chocolate a Calypso superstar.
Well, Black Sage boy, I am an optimist, so I will advise you to please stop your stupidness. Why the hell you want to knock the Calypsonian and say that
is a suspicious plan. His daughter has she own thinking, and I realize she doing she own thing. I telling you, please think positive, because that thing is not even politically motive.
I'm a element of a party. Because I passed there and I rarely see the little girl sitting down whole day by the library. But what I have to tell you in true, this crime, look at what it makes people do. Because I know she make a stance of class. Imagine for quite a few days the girl give a fast. And what I have to say, I'll tell you all. This lady, she going to make crime take a fall.
Balabaday, balabaday. When I really check the situation, from chocolate I get a positive vibration. I telling you now, listen something, because the people say the youths, they cannot do nothing. But that child is a child of her class, and I see she break a 5-day fast. She result, she remain hungry, just to put against crime here in this country.
Live it up on my life.
I love a day.
Lingo, I'm disappointed indeed, but of course I understand you didn't read. It's not 5 days, I am very sure. It ain't 5 days, I think chocolate make more. And after that, the thing was so cool. She even went and write at your end in people's school. And right now, you must consider, she even have a column in Guardian newspaper.
Well, I telling you, listen what I say. I see the girl fasting between Monday and Friday. So partner, listen the tricks, because I believe like you don't know mathematics. Black sage boy, I saw God amount, and I believe that you cannot count. I mean this, my friend, without no disrespect. The truth is, my friend, you cannot check.
Baby, tiba, ba, lai, la, da, la, da, da, do. I may not be able to check indeed, but Lingo, I know for sure that you cannot read. Because I have to tell you and tell you fast, the girl really, she extended the fast. But ladies and gents, make no mistake, I concur with the stance chocolate take. And I will tell all of you on the slime, I wish all of us could be so sensitive about crime.
Balabaday, balabaday. That verse you make, man, you have to regret. Like you don't know there's a thing called the internet. Believe my friend, I am making fun, cause every night I read the Express and the Guardian. So man, look, I have a choice, because I have a computer with a voice. So for you to say I can't read, man, hold your tail, cause I have a computer and I could also read Braille.
Give it up on my line, that I love about you. Give it up, I love about you. Well, with all that reading, I'll tell you in song, somehow you're still getting the damn thing wrong. So of course, I had to state, you're not only blind, but you're also illiterate. But you know, under no pressure, I like what chocolate did, so please consider, Kotalin is smart. No pressure, next year chocolate might be a big soca star. La, ba, ba.
Hey!
Balabadabaday,
balabadabaday, message, boy, without coaching from chocolate. You need some coaching, because I'm telling you, she's a girl of class. Especially when you see she take that fast. When I look at you and the way you dress, well, I'm telling you, my friend, I am not impressed. This is what I am saying, and this is true. Even though I'm blind, I'm matching better than you.
Alamadi papa taya, alamada papa tum taya, la da da taya, la da taya, da taya. I like the line, I had to admit, but I don't know, want to know what it have to do with chocolate. But of course, I will have you know, I don't mind taking that little lash from Lingo. But you know, I had to admit, with that line he said, he's a hypocrite. He giving a thing about dress to me, but even chocolate in the library he never see.
Lingo, Black Sage.
Thank you very much.
No, I'm sure the audience can take two more verses. Free fall. Two more verses, anything.
Well, of course.
Two more verses, any music. Music, please.
Balabade. Balabadoi. Come on the stage, because you know I have to challenge Black Sage. But I telling you, listen carefully, watch a man, he's so damn ugly. But this is what I want all you understand, because look at me, I am a handsome man. Boy, your face so sour, in case you ain't know, if you should spit right here, a lime tree sure to grow.
Ladies and gents, all you understand, I really don't want to beat up a blind man, because I'll tell all you candidly, Lingo is a fella he doesn't see. And with that, hear what going on, Lingo can't even see if he getting horn. I used to crawl all over Lingo head when I'm going and sleep on his sister bed.
Well, this fella imagination is very weird, because he say he used to be crawling over my head. But I telling you, the man should be in sentence, because my sister once decided to give him a chance. But she tell me it was a big mistake, because he only gave she a big headache. Believe me, my friends, what I'm saying is true. Not even Viagra nor your tongue could help you.
Well, of course, I am so happy that the man hitting me extemporaneously, because he tell all of you without a doubt, he said not even Viagra could help me out. What I have to tell him, I'll say candidly, that does not give me no worry. What I have to tell Lingo, and he cannot see, it tell me is your girlfriend who handling me.
Balabaday, balabadabaday, day, balabadabaday.
Thank you very much, Lingo. Thank you very much. Lingo and Black Sage. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much, all of you who stayed back to this end. Thank you very much for your patronage. And the winner of the Extempo 2007 competition, Lingo! Lingo! Breaking new ground, Lingo is our champion Extempo singer for 2007. Come on up and face your audience, please, Lingo. Very well done. You've been knocking on the door for years, and at last you've achieved your ambition. You've worked hard at your craft, And I want to congratulate you on behalf of Tuco for a fabulous job. Would you like to say something?
Jean-Pierre Passey! Awachinalia! I love you. Thank you for the support over the years. Finally, we do it. Yeah! Well, I'm telling you, I don't have to rehearse, because I'm going to give you a Lanya verse right about now. It is clear. Lingo is the champion this year. So all you listen carefully, because I'm dedicating this victory to Big B. Right about now, I feel a release. So I want to say may his soul rest in peace.